Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Media, here today with a video on the Ford 2.3 versus 2.7 EcoBoost, which one is better? Both of these engines share much in common, with the 2.3 and 2.7 liter engines both being a part of Ford's EcoBoost engine family. However, where the 2.7 and 2.3 liter EcoBoost significantly differ is in the size and configuration of the engines, with the 2.3 EcoBoost being an inline four single turbocharged engine and the 2.7 EcoBoost being a twin turbocharged V6. Now, both the 2.3 and 2.7 EcoBoost are available in the Ford Bronco and Ford Ranger. So in both of those vehicles, the 2.3 EcoBoost is going to be the standard engine option with the availability to upgrade to the larger 2.7 EcoBoost. So with some of that background info out of the way, let's go ahead and jump into the bulk of this comparison, starting off with performance. Naturally, the larger 2.7 liter engine is going to have an advantage when it comes to performance. Ultimately, as the saying goes, there is no replacement for displacement. While that isn't always true, it certainly is in this case when we're talking about two engines from the same family. So the 2.3 EcoBoost offers anywhere from 270 to 300 horsepower in the Ford Ranger and Bronco. Now it does make up to 350 horsepower in some other models, such as the Ford Focus RS. However, again, since both of these engines are in the Ranger and Bronco, mostly looking at those numbers here rather than the output of the engines and some other models. Moving on to the 2.7 EcoBoost, this engine delivers anywhere from 315 to 330 horsepower in the Ranger and Bronco. The lower power variant is in the Ford Ranger models, and the higher power variant is in the Ford Bronco. Now, looking at torque, the 2.7 EcoBoost has a 90 foot-pound advantage when it comes to both the Bronco and the Ranger. So again, naturally here, the 2.7 EcoBoost is going to have that advantage due to its larger displacement, V6 layout, as well as its twin turbochargers. And all of that translates into real-world performance figures as well. The 2.7 EcoBoost is going to be anywhere from roughly 5/10 to about 7/10 of a second faster to 60 miles an hour. So really, that wraps up a lot of the basics when it comes to factory performance. However, taking things a step further and talking about aftermarket performance potential, this is where the 2.7 EcoBoost also holds an advantage once again. However, both of these engines are very capable with a tune and simple bolt-on modifications due to their turbocharged design. So ultimately, both of these engines are incredibly easy to modify and pick up an additional 50 to 100 plus horsepower. However, the advantage does remain with the 2.7 EcoBoost, especially considering the fact that from the factory, I would say the 2.3 EcoBoost is a little more aggressively tuned, whereas with the 2.7 EcoBoost, it's a little more conservatively tuned coming from the factory, which ultimately means there's more potential with the larger 2.7 EcoBoost. So talking about a tune and some simple bolt-ons like an intake, potentially downpipes, and a small ethanol blend, the 2.3 EcoBoost can pretty easily make it into the ballpark of about 325 to 350 wheel horsepower. And on the other hand, the 2.7 EcoBoost is relatively easy to take to 450 plus wheel horsepower. So that's where the advantage really starts to grow further in favor of the 2.7 EcoBoost. Looking at those numbers, the 2.7 EcoBoost will end up 100 plus wheel horsepower ahead of the 2.3 EcoBoost, which is a very far cry from the roughly 30 to 45 horsepower difference from the factory, outside of the fact that between the two, the 2.7 EcoBoost is the stronger engine, and it also has the benefit of coming from the factory on the second gen EcoBoost engines, coming from the factory with dual injection, so it has port and direct injection, which can be very important for anyone who's looking to do a really high power, high performance build. Moving on to our next topic, we have reliability. I'll start off by saying reliability between these two engines can really be a toss-up. Some of it comes down to how well the engines are maintained, as well as some luck of the draw, but ultimately both the 2.7 and 2.3 EcoBoost should be reliable engines with proper maintenance and a little bit of luck on your side. I would potentially give a slight edge to the 2.7 EcoBoost, again, circling back to the fact that it has both the direct and port injection on the second generation engines. That does help eliminate carbon buildup, which can be an issue on any engine that only uses direct injection. So that is a good advantage for the 2.7 EcoBoost, specifically, again, that second generation engine, which would be found in both the Ford Ranger and the Ford Bronco. Despite that, one place that does help the 2.3 EcoBoost comes down to basic and general maintenance costs. So being a smaller inline four engine, it is going to be a little cheaper with basic maintenance. It has a lower oil capacity. And additionally, there are going to be four spark plugs, four ignition coils versus six spark plugs, six ignition coils, etc. So that does slightly favor the 2.3 EcoBoost. Now, it's not going to add up to a huge difference in repair bills for one-off oil changes or spark plug changes. But if you are looking to own one of these engines for 8 to 10 years and 100,000 plus miles, that can start to add up to something over the course of, you know, dozens of oil changes and a couple spark plug changes. For the final topic in comparing the 2.3 and 2.7 EcoBoost engines, we have price and fuel economy kind of lumping these together. This is where things really take a turn in favor of the smaller 2.3 liter EcoBoost engine. Upgrading to the 2.7 liter V6 is a roughly $2,000 option. So right off the bat, that gives the advantage to the 2.3 being the base engine and not having any additional costs above and beyond MSRP there. So slight disadvantage for the 2.7 EcoBoost in that you are paying extra money for it. And that's especially true if you're looking to buy a used example. Again, looking at the Ranger and Bronco. For the Ford Ranger, the 2.7 EcoBoost actually wasn't available until 2024. So if you're looking for an older used model or looking for something a little bit cheaper, obviously the 2.3 EcoBoost is going to be one of the few options. And that's where the price gap can change if you're looking at, for example, a 2024 Ranger with the 2.7 EcoBoost versus a 2022 Ranger with the 2.3 EcoBoost. That is going to lead to an even bigger difference in costs. And so that is another drawback to that 2.7 EcoBoost. And then lastly, looking at fuel economy, these engines are relatively close. The 2.3 EcoBoost will return roughly 2 miles per gallon better than the 2.7 EcoBoost. So relatively small difference on the surface, but can add up over the course of years and years and tens of thousands of miles of driving. And on top of that, another thing to point out is that with that extra power and torque of the 2.7 liter engine, if you really find that you're using that power more frequently, then that is going to send fuel economy dropping at a quicker rate than the 2.3 EcoBoost. So while the 2 miles per gallon difference on the surface isn't a huge deal, if you do have a heavier foot, the difference in that fuel economy can start growing a little bit more, further adding to the costs of the larger 2.7 liter engine. Anyway, guys, that really wraps up the main topics and comparisons for the 2.7 versus 2.3 liter EcoBoost. In summary, the 2.7 liter EcoBoost has the natural advantage with its larger displacement and twin turbochargers, which gives it a 30 to 45 horsepower advantage from the factory. And again, 90 pound-feet of torque, so relatively considerable differences straight from the factory, and that grows further for anyone looking to tune and modify these engines. The 2.7 liter EcoBoost has a lot more headroom, and really with a tune and basic bolt-ons can easily achieve 450 plus wheel horsepower compared to about 325 to 350 wheel horsepower for the 2.3 EcoBoost. Looking at reliability, again, it's really a toss-up between these two engines as to which is more reliable. I'd potentially give the slight edge to the 2.7 EcoBoost, but that is washed away in many senses with the fact that the V6 is going to be a little bit more expensive with basic general maintenance. And then lastly, the 2.3 EcoBoost is also going to be the cheaper engine when it comes to buying the vehicle up front, and as well as running costs with fuel economy and the 2.3 EcoBoost delivering roughly 2 miles per gallon better. So as to which engine is better, it really depends on what you're looking for in an engine. If you value power and performance above all else, then you'll probably find a lot more joy in the 2.7 EcoBoost. However, the 2.3 EcoBoost offers plenty of power, plenty of torque for most average drivers. So if you don't really value that and you want something that's a little more cost-friendly, not only upfront, but also at the fuel pump and potentially with some basic general maintenance, then the 2.3 EcoBoost is also an excellent option. Anyway, guys, that wraps up our video for today. If you appreciated the content, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and stay tuned for more in the future. Thanks, everyone.